Hello and welcome back to Dragon Quest Wall Tutorials. I'm Koichi, and in this video we are going to go over some updates and also do a battle against the Giga Monster, so that's going to be Barbaros. So over here in our notices section we're going to have a couple of new things. So from October 19th, we're going to actually have the addition of Quest 6. We're going to have a new quest map for Part 6, so for getting tickets for the Dark Dragon Barbaros banner. Then we're also going to get the second week of the rescue the imprisoned angels. Then also, actually, it's right now the 20th, so from the 20th we're going to get a new Journey of Awakening. That's going to be for the Silver Devil. And then for the 26th we're going to actually have part 7 of the quest map, event quest. We're going to have the addition of a new class, so that's going to be the new class that's going to be level 70 paladin and level 70 superstar. So not sure of what the name is yet, but probably on the smart walk on the next Wednesday we'll get in more information about the name of that class. Then we're also going to get the new mega monster, which is probably going to be the final boss for this game. And then also we're going to have the third part of the rescue the imprisoned angels, so that's going to be what's going on here. So here, like I said, I want to actually do a video on Barbaros. So this time is the second week, so we're going to actually have new information. So in this case, week 2, from the 19th to the 26th, we're going to actually have new bonus actions and also a new Giga attack chance. In this case, the new bonus actions are going to be weapon and physical technique skill damage. Those are going to be bonus actions, so you get 15 points for those, so that's actually going to be really good. Then after that, for the Giga attack chance, pretty much for one turn, the enemy becomes more susceptible or takes more damage from weapon, physical technique, spell, and breath damage. So that actually is quite good. So hopefully with this team, I'm actually going to actually do some pretty good damage. So this is going to be pretty much the exact same team that I did last time in my last video, an EO-based team. That's because the Blade of Ramios on Demon Swordsman actually works quite well. So I actually want to see how well I can do. So here, pretty much for my Guardian Angel, I'm going to have on the Miracle Blade. So that's going to do damage and also heal my character, so that's going to work out quite well in keeping my team alive. Then here, my High Priest is going to have on the Angel Rod, so with the Angel Rod, again, going to heal, and also going to probably use Blade Dance as well to give everyone additional attack power. Then here, for my two Demon Swordsmen, I will have the Blade of Ramios. So again, this is going to have Phantasmal Sword Flash. That's going to give do some very good damage. So if you want to know more about this team, you can look down in the video description down below. But now I want to go ahead and challenge this Giga Monster, so Barbaros. So hopefully I can get in the top 5. If not top 5, hopefully I can get within the top 3. We'll see what happens. But yeah, here we go. Okay, so here we go with this battle. So hopefully, like I said, I can get within the top 5, possibly type 3. We'll see what happens. Okay, so here, going to go ahead, auto battle. So this is going to be my first battle of the day, so I'm actually going to be taking less damage from the enemy. So okay, good, that's good. Let's see how much damage I can do here. So 18,000, that's not bad. Okay. Then here next, my next Demon Swordsman. Okay, 9,000 damage, 700, okay. And then here going to be my Guardian Angel. I don't really need to heal, but that's fine. So next here with my character here, going to go ahead use Blade Dance. And then pretty much from here, ooh, okay. So even with there, I actually did get a full attack power boost. So yeah, that's actually quite good. Okay, good, 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 good. So things are actually, right now, going actually pretty well. So we'll see what happens next here. Okay, so let's see how much damage my Demon Swordsman does here. Before did 18,000, now 25,000. So here going to heal up. Okay. Then, this could actually be pretty good damage here. Let's say 34,000. 29, okay. Then let's see how much I can do here with my Guardian Angel. So that actually is quite good. So now everyone is actually out of the death countdown. So that's actually quite good. Okay, a miss. Okay, that's actually quite good. And, okay. No problem. Okay. I'm actually not out of the death countdown for my two Demon Swordsmen. That's fine, though. But here I should be getting a Giga Attack chance this particular turn. Okay. So, okay. Let's see how much damage here. And a miss. And another miss. Okay. Those misses are going to really mess me up. So, okay. So there goes my Giga Attack chance. Yeah, I feel like I could have done a lot of damage with that attack if it didn't miss. Okay. So hopefully this doesn't miss either. Let's see. Okay, goes in 46,000 damage. Okay. Okay, going to heal up. Hopefully, okay. I didn't get a, hoping to get a charm, but, not a problem. So, Dorma. Okay. Okay, so next turn, he's going to be using his strongest attack. So, we'll see what happens here. Okay, 26,000 damage. And then here, let's see how much damage here. 33,000 damage, not bad. And nice 7,000 damage there. Okay, so that actually gave a heal there. So Miracle Sunrise. So okay, so good. That and with that there, taken out. Okay. And with that, I got a Cecil. Okay, so with fourth place, let's see, I got a new experience orb. So that actually worked out quite well. So fourth place, like I said, I wanted to end up in the top five or even in the top three. But like I said, that one attack that I did miss, that probably would have pushed me up a bit more. Okay, so my prediction of getting within the top five actually worked out. So yeah, I actually got fourth place. Like I said, I probably could have gotten higher if I didn't miss with my Demon Swordsman that one round. But things did actually work out with this particular battle. So you saw Phantasmal Sword Slash actually did very good damage there. And then also had good damage with my Guardian Angel and healing with the Miracle Blade. And then of course, good healing with my High Priest. And then a really good buff right in the beginning, giving all my characters increases to attack damage. So that really worked out quite well. So what I want to do now is actually go over the S grade soul of Barbaros. So you can actually see that right over, right here. So Barbaros is going to be a blue soul. So with blue souls, max HP and then also agility, dexterity are going to be pretty high. Then also strength can be pretty high here. So here we're going to have 133 max HP, plus 81 to max MP. That's actually not so bad. Plus 93 to strength. That's good. Plus 89 to durability. That's actually pretty good too. And then agility and dexterity, both 116. So that's actually quite good. Then actually here we have plus 3% to weapon skill and physical technique damage, plus 7% to shadow damage, and plus 4% to breath resistance. So I'm going to go ahead and lock this in. So of course with this, we're going to be able to create the S star grade pretty much as we go along defeating the enemy. So hopefully it's going to actually have some really good stats and abilities. So we'll see what happens. But with that there, I'm going to end this video here. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. If you would like to see more, please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.